So what makes a story a hit? While there's no magic formula for what makes a story successful, there are a few key elements we see time and time again in serialized stories that really make them click. And that's what we're here to talk about today. I'm Leah, and this is Story School. Werewolves, cyberpunk, urban fantasy, enemies to lovers. It's not about a specific genre or subgenre, as all of these spaces are rich with opportunity. What it is about is the story structure and audience appeal within these spaces. Regardless of what genre you're writing in, stories have potential when there are three things: immediate, engaging, and commercial. So there you have it. Our job here is done. Just kidding. Let's dive into what that means. Stories have to be immediate, and this means there's a clear and compelling hook right in that very first chapter. It's not just about setting the scene or introducing the characters, but the audience has to have a reason to emotionally invest in this story right away. That doesn't mean a story can't be a slow burn, but that central conflict and why an audience will emotionally invest in this story, that has to be introduced in chapter one. Stories have to be engaging. There has to be a core story engine that's driving that whole narrative forward. This enables you to build from that and develop different story arcs from different characters and take those stories in a bunch of different directions, but there has to be a central premise that's really driving that all forward and tying it all together. Readers want to see unique characters with strong motivations. This is really key for serialized storytelling because we're going to be with these characters for such a long period of time. We need to know what they care about and why we should care about them. Cliffhangers! You've got to give readers a reason to come back every day or every week. These are so important for serialized storytelling. Leave them with an unanswered question or something that really hits on that feeling of, but what happens next? So readers have a reason to come back for more. Keep your story engaging by playing into that genre space and really giving readers what they want. Or not, to increase the tension. Think steamy vampire story. You want them to end up together, but maybe we need a sexy werewolf to appear to keep that tension going. Being commercial doesn't mean you have to appeal to the masses or appeal to everyone, but it does mean you need to appeal to readers who are in that genre space. Embrace tropes and conventions that are recognizable within this space. And that doesn't mean your story has to follow a formula. It can subvert these tropes or approach them in a unique way, but it allows your story to be really accessible to readers in this genre. Stories are commercial because they are accessible, even when dealing with deeper themes. We see a lot of stories navigating heartbreak or grief or mental health, and they stay accessible because there are characters and character dynamics that we as the audience are so invested in. A trap writers often fall into is not actually knowing what their story is about. What is that core hook that's grabbing your reader's attention, and what's driving your story forward? Make that hook immediately clear in chapter one, keep it engaging through how you're telling the story, and ensure it's accessible to readers of that space. Thanks for watching, Wattpadders. Catch it in the next episode.